Hey guys, this is Tyler here from Rehab and Fab Designs. Sorry, I just was trying to start a video and I forgot to turn off my Wi-Fi on my phone. When I use it, it tends to make the picture very blurry, so I had to stop it real quick and go turn that off. I am working on this piece you see behind me. It is Black Friday / Small Business Saturday / Cyber Monday weekend. And we're here at the shop. This is our first day back all week. My little boy was out of school for Thanksgiving, and so we took the week off, so I'm excited to be back and start painting. I have this piece here behind me that my husband has started painting. This is being painted in one of the new Wazow chalk synthesis paint colors. This was released recently this fall. It's called Botanical. It's a beautiful, deep, rich, kind of an emeraldy green. And I really love jewel tones, so that's what we're doing on this. The legs will be, if you can see them, natural. We've got them stripped down. We'll leave those natural. And we do have to rebuild the top on this one. It's actually part of a set. If you saw recently, I posted a black vintage chest of drawers that was painted in the 1-hour enamel. So this one goes with it. And we decided to paint it in the color. Let me turn my Christmas music down, sorry. So it doesn't blast you guys out. But this one's going to be green. And the color by itself is very pretty. It's very rich, very deep. But I wanted to add just a little bit more depth to it. So the other day while he was putting a second coat on, I went around the edges here. Let's see if I can turn it a little bit. Went around the edges here with some black paint, just to kind of deepen it a little bit. It doesn't really change a whole lot on it, but as you can see right here, it just adds a little bit more depth in those corners. And the reason I did that, this piece is pretty plain by itself. It does have a little design on the drawer front, so I'll show you those in a little bit, and I'll have to go around those as well. But otherwise, the side panel is just plain. There's no detail, no adornment on it. It does have the raised part here around the frame, and so I just wanted to kind of give it just a little bit more. And so that's what I'm going to do today. We do have a sale going on right now. If anybody wants to try the Wazow paint, we are offering it at 20% off right now through Monday until 11:59 p.m. Our website, rehabtofabdesigns.com. And I'll try to drop a link in the bottom of this video when I finish up. But it's a great time to buy if you want to try it. There's chalk synthesis paint. There's the 1-hour enamel line, which is great if you're wanting to paint your cabinets or a front door or furniture. It really, especially if you're doing like a lot of pieces, it's good to decrease your turnaround time because it dries really hard, cures really hard, and it dries fast in an hour. This is the color we're working with here, just so you can kind of see how rich that is. Very pretty. And then I am using Wazow in just black, and that's what I'm using to kind of go around the edges. This piece has been primed. My husband sanded it down and cleaned it really well. We didn't strip it, just sanded it and primed it. And then it's got two coats of the Botanical on it, the green that you see here. And then this side, I just kind of had started playing with it just to kind of see, you know, what look I wanted to get with it. And I will tell you, I'm going to sand it first. I have a sanding block here. And then this is just 400 grit sandpaper. And I'm just trying to smooth it. I've done a little bit up here just a minute ago. I don't know if you can tell the difference, but this is really soft and smooth. And then the sound kind of deepens when you get down here. And that's just because the texture is a little rougher because chalk paint is more porous. And so I did kind of just run a little bit over it. And when you sand it, you'll see it leaves like a chalk. Just like on a chalkboard, when you like erase the chalk, it leaves that kind of white look. It does leave that kind of look behind after you sand it. But when you seal it, that will go away. I just want to make it smooth. I like nice, smooth furniture pieces. I like to rub my hand on it and it feels really soft. My hands are really rough as it is, so I don't want to feel rough furniture too. So I'll just kind of run my hands across it and when I'm working to see, you know, how it feels. Now I will tell you, when you're adding a little bit of depth and dimension like this using paint, you are creating texture because you're basically adding a little more raised area wherever you're adding this additional paint. So it will give you you will be able to feel it because it's creating texture. So I'm just going to kind of wipe that back. This is just a little shop cloth just to kind of get the dust off. Nothing fancy. You could spray it with a little water if you want. But I'm just trying to get that little bit of dust off there that I just created when I took that sanding pad over it. And again, you want to use a high grit sandpaper. The higher the number, I'm sorry, not a high grit, a low grit number, the higher the number, the lower the grit. So if you use like a 150, it's going to be really rough. And if you use like a 320 or a 400, it's going to be really smooth. And that's what you want to use for your finishing, just to get it nice and smooth. I do have a water bottle here. That's the one I've been using for a little while. It's from Hobby Lobby, Ultra Fine Mist Sprayer. I think it was like 10 bucks, but I got it on sale when it was like 40% off. I have two brushes here. These are Klingon brushes. We also retail these. They are fabulous brushes if you've never tried them before. They're great for blending. The bigger round ones are really, really good for blending. And I like to use those kind of dry for that. But since I'm just going in kind of around the corners here in this, I need a smaller head, so I don't want that big round brush to do that. They're also on sale on our website. We have an Etsy shop as well, but we don't have all the items the same on there. Everything's listed on our website, though, if you want to try them. So I'm just stirring this paint up right now. Just make sure it's good and mixed. Make sure you get all that good pigment off the bottom if it's settled, if it's been a while since you stirred it. And I'm not going to use a whole lot of the black. And I even thought about just kind of mixing it with my botanical. So I don't get too much on it. I only got one spoon. I was ill prepared. I also don't have anything underneath my piece on the floor, and I'm messy. So I'm gonna have to be careful not to make too much of a mess. I'm gonna turn this a little bit. You can see that, not me. And this will be the third coat. So we'll just kind of start with that. My brush is a little bit damp because it's been in the in water since we were here last week. When we clean our brushes, when we finish up with them, we take and rinse them out really well and then drop them in water, and they will basically, when you come back, all the paint will have settled from the bottom of them, or from the brush into the bottom of your container of water. So it's really nice for cleaning. You don't have to spend so much time on your cleanup. How was everybody's Thanksgiving? Everybody eat too much? That's, I think, usually what everybody does. We went to my sister's house this year. We usually eat at my house, but we went to her house this year. We always fix way too much food. And every time we do it, we say we're not going to do it again. We're just going to do something easy. But, you know, it's just something about that time of year. We like to eat the same foods every year. Occasionally we'll add something new, and then it becomes part of the mix, and, you know, can't take anything away. You gotta fix all the same stuff and just add something new. So we end up with way too much food. But it's awesome. We love time together. Wouldn't trade it for anything. Hey, will you get me an extra spoon from under the counter over here? Please. I only got one. Thank you. And the colors change a little bit when they start drying. You'll notice they kind of darken when they're wet. I'm just getting a spoon here so I can get some more paint. I'm trying to be good and not dip into my paint because then the tops get all messy. And I have plates here, so why not use them, right? I think I'm going to start with that, and then I'm going to go ahead and go around this side while it's wet. So I'm using a separate brush and just picking up a little bit of that black paint. And I may even mix it a little bit with the green. And I'm just adding a little bit more depth. When I was kind of playing around with this, I even added a, I think it's the sapphire blue. It's a really bright royal blue color. And I'm just going to add a little bit of dark in here. Just kind of following the corners really is what I'm doing. Now you can get really cool with this and do some drips and stuff too if you want. You can blend it more. Just depends on what kind of look you're going for. But that, I mean, that right there, that's how easy it is to blend this. And you can take, if you want it really soft, you can get another brush, like the round brush, and do dry. But basically just horizontal, vertical strokes, kind of mix them up a little bit, and it will just blend those two colors beautifully right together. It's crazy how easy it is once you start doing it. So for this, I've got more black here in the crease over here where the two pieces meet. And so to blend that, I'm going to keep brushing up and down, and then I'll just kind of work my way out a little bit from this corner out. And what that's doing is kind of picking up the green here in the out here, and so it'll kind of blend them together. I'm going to spray it with a little bit of water just because I feel it kind of dragging because that dried. That's why I didn't paint the whole thing, because I knew it was going to dry before I got to it. But just start pulling it together just like that, and then you've got a little shadow, a little bit of dimension created with your paint. Now you can do this with wax, obviously. You can use dark wax, black wax, and create this same kind of look. But it depends on what I want to seal the piece with, like how much use it's going to get, how much traffic. If it's going to be a heavier use piece, I'll seal it with varnish instead of a wax. If it's more of like an accent piece, I'll do wax just because I really like the way the wax feels. It's a nice buttery smooth finish, and I really like that. So, but again, just because you like the way it looks, also be smart and use what's best for the piece as far as what it's going to be used for. Because if you paint a really pretty piece and it turns out beautiful, but it doesn't hold up, and that's not really doing you a whole lot of good. So choose what's best for the piece. I'm just trying to kind of lean a little bit to see where I'm at. So I did put a little bit of black up here, but I can't even really see it that much because I'm sitting below it. So I think that's good for that. So what I'm going to start doing, I'm going to come back with my green here, with my botanical, and I'm going to do the same thing on this side. And if you feel like this is kind of dry where I stopped here just a minute ago and you don't want it to pull and kind of leave an unsmooth area where you're adding the new, you just spray it with a little water. And that, of course, is for chalk-based paints, not necessarily latex. If you make your own chalk paint, you can spray it with a little water too. It doesn't blend as nice as a real manufactured chalk paint. But I wouldn't recommend it on just like a plain latex type paint because probably not going to mix very well. And I do like nice clean lines. So I tend to kind of go top to bottom with it all. Try to get rid of as many brush strokes as I can. If that's what I'm going for. If you want to do texture and chippy and drippy, then by all means, make messy lines. They will actually help with that. that this is going to be a nice, smooth, clean piece. And that's it for the green. I'm going to come back and pick up a little bit of black on my other brush. Same thing. Just kind of go down here around the edges. And I mean, as soon as you start it, because the green, the botanical is still wet, it'll start blending. So you don't have to do a whole lot of work. Now, if it gets dry, that's a different story. You're going to have to work a little bit harder for it. But this is still nice and wet. And I will tell you, when you start blending, you want to use a nicer, a lighter stroke with your brush, the softer you're trying to get. So when you first start, you know, you can kind of throw it on and brush it. But if you're really trying to get a nice soft blend, you get lighter with your brush strokes. And you really can't blend too much. When I first started, it was, I was scared to do too much, I guess. I didn't want to like mess it up, but I was afraid if I kept going, it was going to mess it up. But then I kind of found that in actuality, the more I did it, the better it looked, the softer it got. And so you just keep going until you get it the way you want it, until you get that soft transition between your colors. Because you don't want to see, if you're really trying to blend, you don't want to see where the black starts and the green stops. You want it to just kind of smoothly blend. I always try to like think like a cloud, you know, when I'm doing it, which sounds crazy, but. So we're going to add that little black all the way down the side right here. And then we'll start pulling it out, just like we did on the other side. And it's that easy. I know my top might be a little bit dry because it kind of sat a minute. And we'll see if I can do it. Or me. I can't see very good up here either because of where I'm sitting. Kind of looking up at a shadow. And I might, on that, pick up a little bit of green. So I've got black up here at the top of my brush and more green on the bottom. And the reason I'm doing that is because this green is kind of dry right here. So I'll just keep my green right there on the bottom. And then kind of drag it across. And then same thing. And you can do this with as many coats as you want. So if you do it and you're not really liking the way it looks, let it dry. Keeping it wet with the water will keep your paint moving so that you can keep working with it. But eventually you'll see where it's already starting to dry. You can't really, even if you spray it, it's going to kind of leave brush strokes. So just kind of leave that alone. And then you'll come back after it dries and do another coat and get that look you're going for. And this is just the botanical here. I think that's a little dry right there, so I'm gonna stop on that. I'll do these sides right here. And then I'll turn it and do the other side. So when I did this the other day, I did add a little bit also to these, to the frame here. Just kind of at the top and bottom. And I don't know why, but you'll see too, if you start blending the frames of pieces, they always seem to blend better. Maybe because it's smaller, I don't know. It just blends really pretty. I'm trying to get this on the edge of this without getting all that green paint right there where I just added the black right here on the flat panel part. And the reason I'm doing this whole piece again is just because I didn't want to put a third coat on this whole piece. Just because it's a really a rich color. And it does have a white primer underneath. You do get good coverage with it. I'm trying to turn my volume up. Y'all can't hear it now. So that was the botanical. Picking up a little bit of black. And I'm just going to add it right here. Same thing down here. And you can spray it a little bit. This is the botanical brush. And so it's a little bit darker here and a little bit darker down here at the bottom. And you can kind of see where this is really starting to look really good there. So you got some nice highlights, low lights, if you will, dimension created with paint instead of wax. You can also use a glaze if you're wanting to add a little dimension to a piece. I really like glaze. It makes a really pretty look. And it's great if you're working on a detailed piece, because when you use a glaze, it will sit in the low spots on the piece that you're working on your detail. And so, like for example here, and you can just kind of rub your thumb across it. My husband's really good at it. And leave the glaze sitting in the low areas. So like you could do the same thing here, around here. It's just, it requires a little more work. Because when we glaze, we always paint the piece. So we'll prime it and prep it as usual, and then paint it with probably 2, maybe 3 coats of paint, depending on coverage and what we're doing. And then we will seal it with another 2 coats of whatever top coat, sealer, whatever we're using, not a wax, usually a polycrylic type sealer. And then, after that dries, then we'll start the glaze process. And the reason we do that is because, like I said earlier, chalk paint is very porous in nature. If you don't know what porous is, imagine a countertop that is smooth, like as glass with no divots in it, versus like a laminate maybe type, or a cheaper style that has little holes all in it, in the surface of the countertop. So those holes are what makes it porous. So your dirt on a countertop will sit in all those holes. Same thing with chalk paint. If you're painting and you don't seal it and then you put the glaze over top of it, it's going to sit in all the holes on the surface area, and it's gonna be harder to get out. So if you seal it first, you have a really nice smooth piece, so you can put your glaze on and then wipe it back easily. It just gives you a little more control over it, if you will. So you can kind of control a little bit better where your glaze is going and how hard it is to get off if you have it in an area you don't want it, and just kind of where it sits. So on this part of the trim here, let's see if you can see the whole thing in the camera. So I put another coat of the botanical here, and then over here and over here on this other corner right there, I just added a little bit of the black, just to kind of give a little bit of depth right there. And then I'm gonna go back. This is my botanical brush, and I'm just kind of adding a little in the middle. And then I'm just going to kind of blend it out just a little bit. And Now this right here is actually where your separate brush would come in handy. Like I said earlier, the reason I'm using these two and just these two alone is because I'm going around the corners. For this, if you had another third brush, it would be good because you can use that as a dry brush to blend these two paints together. Because when I'm using this, if I'm using, this is my botanical brush, I am getting a little black paint on it. And then if I use my black one, it's kind of getting a little bit of the dark paint, which is okay. You can always wipe it off on your towel. And I think I am liking how that is looking. It's so hard to be a little bit compulsive with your designs. A little OCD, looking for perfection always. So that's it for that side. I've got this one other side right here that I'll do. So we'll go back to our botanical. Hey, Tiffany. Hey, Susan. Say hi if you guys are on here. I don't know when I'm painting if all, I'm not sure if my comments pop up delayed or not. I think they do, but I'm not 100% sure. I'm no expert at the lives for sure. So, going back to the botanical here. I think I forgot to sand this corner because it sounds a little bit rough. Bottom, just like I did here on the other one. Just a little. I do kind of like it right here on the side too, so it kind of blends with that. That's how I did it the other day. Try because this flat panel here is already kind of dry, so I don't want to mess that up. Let's see if I can control my brush. Keep it just here on the corner just to give me a little bit, because if not, you go from dark to light. We want this to kind of look like it's natural. We'll put a little bit of the dark right there. And spray a little bit of water. Not much. A hard time seeing up here in the corner because of the light. I think that'll get us on that. I just did the same thing here. I just added a little bit of black to this top of the trim here, so it kind of goes with that. And since I'm doing that, I'm going to go back on this one and hope that it's not dry.
After
looking pretty, guys. Looking pretty. That's it for that. Hey, Sue, what are you doing? I told you, look, we're over here blending a little bit. Sue has been working on a black cherry piece. She ordered my tutorial for the black cherry piece, and she's in Europe, and she was able to find somebody. We found a retailer for her over there, so she was able to get the Wise Owl paint, and she is working on a dresser. Or chest of drawers, actually, and it is beautiful. Sue, I want you to post pictures on here so Sue, whoever is on here can see it. It's beautiful. She's also got a paper from Redesign with Prima that she's putting on the drawers, and it is gorgeous. Talk about jewel tone colors. So, so pretty. I'm going to jump up and turn this and hopefully not put my butt in your all's faces. Such a klutz, y'all. I get paint everywhere. I really have to be careful on the floor here. All right, so we're gonna do the same thing over here. This, by the way, is the botanical all by itself. And see, it's really pretty. It's a beautiful dark color. So I'm gonna do the same thing over here, just so we can add a little bit of depth around the corners. I'm gonna be good and spoon out my paint so I don't contaminate my. And here's Sam from the Copper Elm. She'll be so proud of me. Somebody tag her. She'll be proud of me for spooning out my paint. Look, and then I dipped it right in my can. So same thing over here. I'm gonna do like half at a time. That way it doesn't dry on me too fast. Uh-oh, this one's not sanded. I guess I'll have to do it in a minute. Real life on the lives, y'all. We might have to chitty chat while that dries for a minute so I can sand it. I forgot to sand this one. I got excited when I started painting. So recap, if you're just jumping on here, I'm using a 400 grit sandpaper. Love that green, if only I could blend. Oh, you're working on your little dog coat. That's so cute. You can blend, you just gotta keep practicing. I'm telling you, it's not that bad. The more you do it, the easier it'll get. Look, when we first started trying to blend, we were using homemade chalk paint that we were making using Bear latex paint, and we were blending with it, and we were making it work. But I will tell you, it was a lot harder using that paint than it is using Wise Owl. And I'm not just saying that, it really was harder. It just took a lot more work. It can be done, just takes a little more work. So now I have paint on my dry dust towel. I'm just gonna fold that. I'm probably gonna let this dry and then come sand it, because again, I want it to be smooth. I like smooth finish. I always say this on my videos, so if you've seen them before, you'll get tired of hearing about it. But if I go like to a store, which I never do because all I do is work, but if I ever go anywhere and see somebody else's stuff, the first thing I do is like rub it and feel it to see if it's smooth. I'm making a mess. see all on my floor. Shh. Don't tell anybody. I'm probably gonna have a green paint on my head too. Where did that go? Get the drawers and show those to you. I think we've got a, how many coats are on the trim in here? On the inside, two? I think that's probably good. So we painted, that's what I was asking my husband because he put the first two coats on the trim here. We did paint it. I think it's got two coats on it. So we'll probably be done with that. Just a little bit. If I can smooth it. The hard thing is if you're sanding on like detailed parts is to do it without your paint completely off. If you're working on like a high raised area like these right here, that's how you distress furniture, right? You use sandpaper or a sander, and that's how you distress it if you want like the wood grain or something to show underneath. So you have to be careful because if you hit those high ridges with your sandpaper, it's gonna go down to your primer. So I think that's it. Here, while that dries, I'm gonna go grab the drawers and I'll show you how pretty they are. So this one has three drawers. It is like the chest of drawers, the black that I just did. I am going to do a little bit of the darker around the edges here on the detail. This is why every furniture painter you know will say they don't understand how they can be overweight or not have massive muscles. This stuff is kidding, y'all. Isn't that pretty? Let's see that detail. What that looks like. Isn't that pretty? So my plan is after I finish the sides, I'm probably going to add a little bit of the depth and dimension with the same technique I'm doing here, just kind of around these details, just to kind of make them pop. And I may go back afterwards and use some black wax to also accent the darker color. It's really pretty. And I'm loving the botanical. Very rich, deep color. Definitely need to grease the wheels. Sue, are you still on here? You will totally appreciate my shirt. Look. This is nurses. We can't fix stupid, but we can sedate it. Isn't that funny? My daddy bought me that. He buys me the funniest nursing shirts. So that is still drying. I guess I can start on this side here. Get something to drink now. I'm hot. Isn't that pretty? I know, Sue, it's a really pretty color. I'm trying to listen to my Christmas music already. I love it. I could almost listen to it all year, but then I feel like I would not appreciate it as much. All right, let me get my brushes separated again. Start painting again. So back with the botanical. Who's starting Christmas shopping already? Oh, I haven't bought anything. I don't like to be a procrastinator, but my work schedule usually makes me one, unfortunately. Nurses do rule. Sue was a nurse also. She would appreciate my shirt. My husband informed me this morning that my little boy got on Amazon yesterday and added a lot of items to my cart that he wants for Christmas. He loves to watch YouTubers. And he says he's gonna get rich being a YouTuber and let me quit work. So, I mean, I don't really think that's a bad idea, so. How can I not support it, right? Thank goodness my husband logged out of Amazon so he couldn't purchase it. I don't really think he would have anyways. He knows better, but I think. That looking? Do they even have the color right? Go back over all this. Nice, smooth, even strokes top to bottom. Okay, so that was give us a nice, smooth finish. Hopefully, little brush strokes. So I'll start with the black on this side while that's still drying, and then I'll try to sand that last little patch and come back to it. Hopefully, I can get it all in one and not have to wait on it to dry too much. Let's see. A dry spot. Get that. So, picking up the other brush with the cling on here, shorty, it's a S30, and getting my black chalk paint. And if it starts getting dry, we're gonna spritz it with a little water. And then, like I said before, so we put the paint right here down the this line right here where the frame meets the panel. So just right down that line. And so to blend that out, we're just gonna kind of start working it back towards the middle. And I do like to kind of put a little corner on it where it goes across the top and the bottom. And I do like horizontal and vertical strokes with my brush when I blend in. Just kind of softens it, and you just kind of keep adding it. So I see a little bit here where it's darker, but I want a little bit more. So I'm just going to add some more black paint and just follow that crease again. And it's hard sitting where I'm at with this light because the light makes it look like there's a really dark line here, but it's really the shadow from this other piece. So try to paint with good lighting and also let it dry and then kind of come back and look at it, and then you can always make changes if you need to, because it will change as it dries, because the color will look a little darker when it's wet. All right, Sue, you see that? Super easy right here. Hey, Priya. Just blending that black into the green. Same thing there. And then, let's see if that's still wet up there. I'm gonna put a little bit of black across here. And then, like I did before, I'm gonna pick up a little bit of green paint on here. Hey, Kelly. Yeah, this is one of the new colors from YSL from the fall release. It's called Botanical, and it is so pretty. Sue, I promise you it'll get easier. Look, I just put my green on my black. The best piece to start on, like if you want to practice blending, is something like a cabinet door. If you have an old cabinet door, we have Habitat Restores here. Priya knows about those. But you can find like lots of cabinet doors and stuff like that at them, or just get an old piece and practice on that. It is easier on the flat piece. And like the trim, like I was saying, like right here. And I don't know if it's just because it's smaller and you're not adding as much, but just put your paint, your base coat all over this whole thing. Just add a little bit of your, whatever you're blending to the ends. Or if you're trying to do it lighter in the middle, like I did on this set that you see behind me, the River Rock, I added Snow Owl just to lighten it right in the middle. And you just fan it out and it just does great. This is drying because I'm talking, so I think I'll leave that. I can start this. I may just leave that unsanded there, y'all, and see how it does because it's still wet, so I can't really do it. I need to turn my fan on. So I'll do this piece here, and then I'll go do that one. We'll see. I may just have to, like I say, leave it unsanded on that little corner and do it after it's done. It'll be white, like I told you guys earlier. When you sand it, it'll leave that kind of white, chalky look. But when you seal it, that'll go away. Can I just say, I love it when you guys comment on here because it makes it so much easier to do this. I hate sitting here talking to myself. I feel so strange. So I love it when I see these little comments pop up, because then I feel like I'm not by myself. So keep commenting. All right, so there's my Botanical. I'm gonna spray that because I'll tell you my paint is getting a little bit dry on my plate. So I'm gonna add the black here. I'm gonna add the black here. Pull that green down in there. Pull the green up into the black. And then I'll go back with this. This is my brush that had my black on it. And I'm gonna go horizontal on it. And back vertical. And I'm also going to add a little black here like I did a minute ago on the other side. Just so it kind of goes with this piece here. I'm going to brush this one horizontally and I'll come back down. And really light strokes. That's the other thing, Sue. Really light strokes when you're trying to get that nice soft blend. As you're getting your colors kind of lighter and lighter, making them blend better together, I kind of really lighten my grip on the paintbrush and just barely light as a feather, brush it over it. And that will just kind of help really also blend your colors. That and going doing the horizontal and the vertical brush strokes really blends it better. wide is it better. So that's it for that. I'm gonna do the bottom here. I hope my picture's clear. I hope it's been clear. I turned off my Wi-Fi on my phone. So hopefully it's good and clear. Usually if I leave my Wi-Fi on, it's very blurry. Like the whole thing every time I move. So I hope this turns out good. Sometimes I will take a video ahead of time and then try to post it. But y'all, it takes like forever to load. Even Instagram, if you try to do it on there, it takes a day and a half, 2 days. Maybe it's just our Wi-Fi, I don't know. But it takes forever. I say that, it probably really is our Wi-Fi because my phone was broke recently. I had no phone for like 3 weeks. I have, we use the iPhone, Apple iPhone, and my phone stopped working. It was like an iPod, basically. I couldn't call or text for 3 weeks. So I went to get it fixed. It was a problem with the model number. I guess it had kind of a recall on it. So Apple said they would fix it for free. And I took it to the Apple store. And because I had a little crack in my screen, they make you fix the screen first. I.e. just to get some money, you know, because they're fixing it for free. And so it was going to be like $160. And my phone's 2 years old. I just paid it off. So I just decided to upgrade and get a whole new phone. But back to my original story. I was trying to back up all my photos. I was trying to back everything up to the cloud because I've never done it. I think it automatically backed up when I first got the phone for, I don't know, a year. And then it quit because I ran out of space because I have way too many photos on my phone. And so I was trying to get my phone to back up to the cloud so I could save all my photos because I didn't want to lose them. And when I plugged it up at my Wi-Fi at home and also here at the shop, the time that it was going to take to complete just kept increasing. And it was going to take like a week. And I kept having to cancel appointments at Apple because it would not download and save all my photos. So I finally took it, my phone, to work with me one day, and I plugged it into the wall at the hospital, and I thought, well, I'll try one more time to, you know, back all my stuff up on the Wi-Fi at work. It backed up in an hour. No, I'm sorry, like 3 hours. But just so you see the difference in the Wi-Fi, so it probably is my Wi-Fi. Because obviously it's not very good. Okay, so same thing over here. Botanical on this frame. And then I'm going to pick up a little bit of the black. Put it up here. And down here. I'm going to feather it lightly. Brush it both ways. And just blend that in. I think that's all I can do until I finish.
Many people go without to keep them warm, but together we can change that. Join Burlington in their annual paint drive. Now through January
4th, I'm going to do this last corner, and then we'll be done. So this right here I did a few minutes ago, so it's kind of dry, so I'm just going to spray that little corner there where these two lines meet. On my plate, rather. And we are almost done with the frame. So all I have left is the drawers. There's that. I need some more black. I'm gonna pick that up and go right down this crease right here. Good thing my husband taped off the top, huh? Because I'm gonna be painting all over that newspaper. So this is the botanical. I just picked back up to go over that a little bit. I'm just kind of blending that black out right here on the bottom. Getting a little bit on the top right here of the trim and the rest. I just knocked my water bottle in my paint lid. So just sprayed that a little bit because it is drying. So I'm trying not to do a whole lot over here because in this corner here because it's dry. So just kind of blending that up a little bit. And then I can come back after that dries completely and we can add to it if we need to. More green here. So this is where in the corners I want to do it so that I don't want to do like a straight line around it. I want it to kind of be rounded corner here. So I kind of brush up a little bit more higher there. And then again, both ways, vertical and horizontal will help blend it better. But we want that darker shading to kind of just come around like that. And that's why we're doing that. I cannot see the top, y'all. The glare is too much. I'm gonna have to move it to the other side. See how it's looking, because I really can't see it from the glare. That's the good thing about it, is paint. If you don't like it, paint back over it and start again. I'm gonna leave that alone. A little more dark right here. Kind of getting where I want it right there. So I'll leave it like that. And then I think I'll leave you guys with that because I feel like I've been on here forever. And I know people do not have an attention span that lasts for hours. So I think I'm going to leave it with that. I'm going to let it dry and then I'll kind of come back and see how it's looking after it's dry to see if I got any blotchy areas. And if so, I'll add another coat because, you know, you just keep going with it. Oh, I need to leave this alone. I hope I don't mess it up. It's looking blotchy right here, so it's bothering me. But it's already dry, so I'll spray it a little bit, but I'll probably have to wait on it and come back later. That's my aiming for perfection I told you about that can cause problems sometimes. Because I can't leave it alone. But that's it. I'm going to leave it alone. I appreciate you guys getting on here and watching. I hope you guys have had a good Thanksgiving week. And just a recap again, this is Botanical is my primary color here. And then I use just black. I won't show you the lid to kind of add some dimension around the corners here. Let's see if I can scoot it back a little bit so you can kind of see the whole thing. That's what it's looking like. I just gave it a little dimension so it's not so flat because it's a pretty simple side panel here. We do have a sale going on right now for Black Friday / Cyber Monday. All Wise Owl products and our Klingon brushes on our website are on sale 20% off. That goes through Monday at 10:50 or 11:59 p.m. If you guys would like to give anything a try, just let us know. Thanks for watching. Bye.